this. So this is courtesy of Hypebeast regarding a Cold War and Timberland linking up. I have to give a Cold War lob credit because I feel like their Timberland's collaborations actually make me want to wear Timberland's. I was one of those idiots that believed that Timberland's was racist because of the tree, and allegedly the tree was the tree they used to hang black people on and shit. I don't know why I believed that fucking nonsense, but I never wore Timberland boots because of that, right? And then I found that through some smarter people that that shit isn't actually true. So I'm now, you know, open to wearing some Timberland's. But sometimes the boot shape can be a bit weird and kind of look weird on my feet and shit. But I love what a Cold War have done with the classic Timberland boot, because I feel like this is something I would wear in a heartbeat. Because to be honest, it looks a little bit like a Rick Owens boot. That's probably why I like them. They look a little bit like a Geo basket in terms of a Timberland boot. If you're not looking at the picture, essentially it's the classic Timberland boot that you all know and love in a black, but essentially they have taken away the laces and made it all one piece kind of looking on the upper, and it has this really sleek design. And maybe the sole has been thickened up a little bit, but I like just the upper shape of it. It looks so fucking good, and I think it's like a nubuck or a suede type of material. I'm not really too sure. I might have to read the description after a while, but they look so great. And then on the instep, you got this nice chunky zip, and then that you obviously you can open it up and kind of fit into them a little bit more easy. But I love how these look. They've got a bit of a split here, so you can kind of open up a bit on the top. They look really great. You got a little bit of the logo here on the front of the toe box. That looks really cool. Only thing issue, this has kind of been screened, I guess, embossed or something. So after a few wears, this might end up flaking off, which might actually make it look cooler, to be fair, over time. But I do like the fact that these will scuff up and pick up a lot of marks, because it looks like it might be nubuck in the upper material. So I do actually like the actual look of it. And I like them, the look of it more so when you see a picture of somebody actually wearing them on foot. Like, look how good these look down, looking down on your feet, because this is a good test of a boot. Look how good these look from the top down. They look fucking gorgeous, man. Like, so well fucking done. They kind of remind me a little bit of the Air Force One that they made back in the day. These shoes I'm not really the biggest fan of, again, but I don't know what the version of this shoe is called, but they actually do make them look quite decent at the top here. I'm not sure if that is a Gore-Tex upper, it looks like, isn't it? I think so. I'm not too sure. But let's just check. The other picture I thought that made them look really good is this lifestyle image here on their Instagram. This lifestyle image with the guy wearing some nice baggy socks and some shorts and shit, or whatever it may be, or jorts. These make them look really fucking good. Like, I want a pair so bad. Like, look at that. They style them in this shoot really well. They look amazing, these Timberlands. I'm sure they're going to be crazy expensive, don't get me wrong. And I'll probably end up having to wait to get them on sale. But they look so fucking good. I want a pair of these so badly. So anyway, the blurb, courtesy of Hypebeast. It says, a Cold War's teaming up a second installment with Timberland as a part of the company's Future 73 initiative. This sees a number of good global tastemakers reimagine the brand's catalogue, which it lists British designer Samuel Ross as he represents. What does that even mean? Yo, Hypebeast writers, bro. He re-presents. Okay, whatever. Starting with the premium 6-inch zip boot, Ross characteristically opts for a minimal aesthetic as he dresses the shoe down in a supple jet black regenerative leather across the upper. What's a regenerative leather? Is that another word for saying nubuck? Regenerative leather. Huh. Which is equipped with a hefty lug outsole and a sleek side zipper by the inside. For more low top, there's a free eye lug shoe, which is complemented by water resistant Gore-Tex lining the top, which is similarly rugged and outsole. Okay, cool. So this shoe, the freehole one, is Gore-Tex, which is quite nice. So you can stomp around in the rain with these on. You could jump in Clapton Pond and actually be okay. Nice to fucking see. And again, talking about somebody representation, right? Like, talking about representation and shit, Samuel Ross just does the thing. No big roo-ha-ha, no fucking massive manifesto. He's not fucking, yeah, I mean, he's not fucking got pictures of, who's that guy again? Martin Lawrence on a t-shirt, you know what I mean? Trying to depict black pain, RIP to him, but do you know what I mean? He's not doing all that shit. He's just showing and proving by works and deeds. So big up Samuel Ross and the team at Cold War. The collection is going to be available on August 29th, so it's already available now. Let's actually see what the price is saying and if it's sold out or not. I'm saying 300. right? Let me say, I'm saying about 300. Let's say, I'm saying 300 in terms of price. Let's see if it's available. Is it on the main page? Yes, there it is there, right? Let's see, shot the collection. I'm saying 375 is my guess in terms of retail. Let's see if it's more. If it's five bills, that's wild. Let's see. I like how they got my man to sell in the box because he's too short. This guy from, what's his, I forgot the brand, what the shop he has. I forgot his name, but they got him sitting in the box. let me see how much the boots are. Let's see if we can get them here. Oh, shit. Oh, $2.95. Okay. Decent. $2.95. I ain't too mad at that. I'm not too mad at that. $2.95. Not mad at out of the slightest, to be fair. That's okay. Oh, yeah, that's his name. Humberto Leon, yeah, from Opening Ceremony. The amount of stuff I got on sale at Opening Ceremony back in the day, man. I still remember, what was that brand called? Was it Peg Leg? I must have bought like four tracksuits from Peg Leg back in the day, like floral ones. I don't even know where they are. I don't even know where, if I lost them, I don't know where they are. But I bought like three of those fucking tracksuits. Like, I think I paid more for shipping than I paid for them individually. They had some crazy sale back in the day. So yeah, the boots I want, they all sold out, unfortunately. So, you know, it's not happening. It all sold out, as you can see there. Only size 7 is left, but they are only £2.95, £300. So yeah, not too bad. PGL loves Peg Leg. PGL getting PTSD from hearing them. But yeah, oh, fuck a survey, fuck off. But yeah, nice shoes. I didn't even see the sole was really icy as well, so they look fucking fantastic. Big up Samuel Ross for doing the damn thing. Big up Samuel Ross for doing the damn thing.